Traffic accidents can occur in an instant. Things happen unexpectedly, and drivers have no time to respond. More often than not, such incidents involve both drivers. Your equipment, or the other car, might suffer costly damage. You or the other driver might get seriously injured, or worse. Non-farm motorists tend not to understand the hazards of approaching slow-moving farm equipment and can become impatient when they need to slow down. In most cases, the root cause of these accidents is human error, not following the rules of the road or not anticipating the actions of other motorists. By changing how you think about driving farm machinery on roads, you can help everyone go home safely night after night. As you'd expect, the everyday rules of the road, obeying stop signs and traffic lights, yielding at right-of-ways, still apply to farm vehicles. And if you engage in texting while driving, if you don't have the required lights on your equipment, if you fail to signal when turning, and if you're driving with an unstable load that could fall onto the road, you could face charges under the Highway Traffic Act. Farm vehicles are permitted to drive on the paved portion of public roads, staying to the right of the center line. But you must share the road with motor vehicles traveling in both directions by moving over and leaving half the roadway clear. To stay safe when moving over, pay extra attention to soft shoulders or obstacles such as potholes or mailboxes that could affect your steering and ultimately compromise your tractor stability. Rear-end collisions are one of the most common accidents involving farm equipment on the road, and a key cause of these collisions is closure time. When two cars are both traveling in the same direction at similar speeds, the chance of them colliding is relatively low. But when a car that's going 70 kilometers an hour comes upon a tractor doing only 25 kilometers an hour, there is precious little time for the car's driver to see the tractor up ahead and then react accordingly. And if the car driver is distracted by talking on the phone or sipping their coffee, there's a very good chance they will crash into the rear end of the tractor. These collisions don't just occur in bad weather or on slippery roads. About 80% of tractor-car collisions happen in broad daylight on straight, dry roads. As the farm equipment driver, you can reduce the risk of a rear-end collision by keeping an eye out for what's happening around you and by being as visible as possible to other traffic. The slow-moving vehicle sign, mounted on the rear of your farm vehicle, is specially designed to make you more visible and thus help prevent rear-end collisions. An SMV sign is required on every tractor, wagon, or other piece of equipment that travels slower than 40 kilometers an hour. The sign must be mounted in clear view and be in good condition. Farm equipment must have white headlights and red taillights, so other motorists can see you and so you can clearly indicate when you're slowing down, stopping and turning. Whenever you're driving farm equipment on rural roads, start out by following three simple steps. First, stop. Ask yourself, what could go wrong? Could my tractor get hit from behind by a car? Could the wagon I'm pulling come unhitched? How bad could it be? Could the driver of the car that hit me be seriously injured or even killed? Could the load in my wagon spill and block traffic? Has anything changed? Is the sun low in the sky, making it hard to see? Is this the first time I've driven on this road? Second, take a moment to think. Do I understand the task? Do I know the correct way to drive when my tractor's front bucket is carrying a heavy load? Do I know the proper hand signals to use when turning? Am I physically and mentally ready for the job at hand? Am I stressed or distracted? Am I taking any medication that affects my concentration? Do I have the right tools and equipment? Does my tractor have ROPS and a seatbelt? Am I using the correct hitch pins and chains? And finally, act. Make it safe. Conduct a pre-trip inspection to ensure your equipment is in good repair and loads are properly secured. Be sure to signal when turning. Use the right tools and equipment. Lock your brakes together when driving on roads. Carry a fully charged cell phone. Reduce risks. Always be aware of the other drivers on the road. Avoid distractions. Wait until you're stopped before using your phone. If you can, stay off heavily traveled roads during busy periods. If you have any doubt whether you can complete the task safely, stop. Don't do it. By anticipating the risks of driving farm equipment on rural roads and taking action to overcome those risks, you can help ensure that nobody gets hurt. Thanks to Dowler Carn and Esso for supporting the production of this video. To learn more about rural road safety and about Stop, Think, Act, visit wsps.ca/farmsafety.